money is becoming even more important.
There is no point at your life on which money will not affect you.
And even years after, the same truths I have tested.
And just the release from the constant tension and strain.
Is to just give us rest.
It is a practical life skill change.
If I knew about this, it is something someone should even do before they get married.
A bit different from what we thought it will be.
In the beginning, it was very complicated. I found it very difficult. But as I progressed, I thought, I think this is good.
An idea born out of adversity evolved to become a movement impacting households all over Kenya and beyond.
We were first mentored in financial freedom in 2008-2009. And at the time we were in quite a bind in terms of our personal finances. And you are struggling to just have the right perspective as concerns money, and also we're in quite deep in terms of debt.
I think there are many things out there that would probably speak to a situation like that, but I was very particular. I wanted something that had truth. Truth tested by time, truth tested by experience.
I've been the main author of the book Mixing God with Money that gave birth to financial freedom for families training. The inspiration for this book actually came from a very, very painful experience that my wife and I went through over 15 years ago. My wife and I had gone as missionaries to Eldoret, and we set up to build a home for the family. And within our cash flow projections, it was going to take us like 6 months to a year to complete, because the dollar was at 18, a bag of cement was at 80 shillings, and we borrowed the money in dollars, and we intended to finish building within about a year and pay back over 5 or 6 years. But Kenya's economy went into turmoil at that time. So when I went to the bank to ask them to delay my repayments, the bank manager was very annoyed with me because he knew I was a missionary, and he told me very, very angrily, "Please give me my money. Don't mix God with money." And that's really where the title came from, because I walked away from that bank asking myself, was it wrong to trust God and mix God with money?
Financial Freedom for Families came out of Dennis's book, Mixing God with Money. And I remember sitting up many hours to read the manuscript before the publishers came in.
I met Dennis Tongoi, he came to join CMS, and at that time, that's the first time I came across his book as well, Mixing God with Money. And after reading the book, I found it quite inspirational and useful, and thought what it needed was a study guide.
And then we were to personalize what we studied the last two sessions to our situation. And maybe it would just be interesting to hear what the experience has been.
What I wish it was, I wish I knew these things when I was very young.
So the first partner you have in financial management is God.
So for me, the budget is really helping us as a family.
Financial Freedom for Families, F4, is a practical approach to handling finances to the glory of God and sustenance of family.
And when you say financial freedom for families, in fact, we'd actually had a longer name for it. Financial freedom for families to the fourth generation.
Well, the first things we cover is a topic of stewardship. Once we get through that, it finds it's a great opening for people to then be able to be open to discussing the other issues of financial freedom, such as saving, investing, debt, good debt, bad debt, as well as planning for the future, how to manage your expenses, how to prioritize expenses, how to work within a family.
Six sessions spread across a given period of time. Fun, engaging, practical, and inspired from the Bible. It is an experience that promises results.
In 2012, when we were planning the ministries of the church, we felt we need to teach our new congregation about how to handle their finances.
I was introduced to this financial for freedom for family by a friend, and then he told me he now introduced me to the financial freedom and how I can be able to benefit. When I listened to what he was talking about, I thought it wasn't only for me. I could also be able to introduce that to the members of staff in my institution, because I thought it was very important. When I joined the institution, I realized that there was a lot of requesting for salary advance when the man was still very young. So I thought there should be something which is not right. I think that caused me to thought of wanting to expose my members of staff to some training concerning finances.
One of the things that we saw, the income of the church has increased. Like from 50 registered members, every month we see the income increasing without even pushing them to give.
Bringing together participants cutting across all generations with relevance and impact in equal measure, focusing on the strength of the family.
It's actually very interesting how I learned about the financial freedom course. We were in a leadership training, and then there was a book that had been placed by CMS Africa on one of the tables. Then I started perusing it through with my friend. And then we thought, interesting, financial freedom for families.
Therefore, I contacted Henry and told him, we'll be interested to get to know what is all this thing. We actually had no information on what it's all about. Just knew it. Maybe it's something that sounded interesting, it was appealing. I think our hearts were very ready for that.
If I knew about this, it is something someone should even do before they get married, you know? Because it's coming at a time, yeah, we've been married for 7 years. A lot has happened. We've gotten into, done a lot of financial, how can I call it? We've done a lot of things maybe if we knew, we wouldn't have done. You know, like getting into extreme debt in one way or another and now having to work your way out of it. If I was to conclude the whole program in terms of finances, financial freedom, I would say, I'd call it something to do with intentional stewardship.
One of the main things that I've learned in this program is the issue of telling money where to go, not money telling me where to go. I think I kept finding myself in the place where, because I have this amount of money, because of the nature of my kind of work at times, I can easily get some substantial paychecks once in a while. So that money at times decides what I'll do rather than me choosing what to do. I'm placed in that position as a steward. And so it's God who I should seek in terms of what to do with this money, not this money directing what I should do with it. So that for me has been very, very profound.
I think for us as a couple, having gone through the financial freedom training, one of the things that we have really come to learn and to do is a lot of communication. Because it's really important, especially in marriage, because now finances have to do with the two of us. So that kind of communication, and then a lot of planning, which is actually very proactive planning, because now we can't just wait for money to come and then we think through it. We ask ourselves, even when money comes, and even the fact that we have to ask God about it, God, now we have these resources, what do we do? That we need to communicate. And also the whole aspect of accountability. We need to ask each other, have you filled your records for the day? And eventually, either weekly or monthly, what are the records speaking to us in terms of our planning? Yeah.
In addition to that, I think one a real aspect which came to light was the aspect of giving. That more than just tithing, giving is a very deliberate act. It's expected of us as Christians, and it's something that we can actually, in prayer, commit to God by faith, knowing what we are giving, allocate resources for that, and actually be very deliberate about the whole issue of giving. And I think that has really even helped us be able to be not only be accountable to each other, but also be responsible in terms of the giving. We are able to say yes, knowing we are saying yes because it has been allocated for, or say no from a very clear conscience and be at peace about that. So that has been very key to us, and we thank God for that aspect of learning.
as we have continued to develop it and refine it over the years, is that it's very practical in nature. Because it's one thing for me to stand and talk to people and tell them, oh, you know, you need to have budget, you need to plan, you know, when you're investing, look out for these things. It's one thing to talk to somebody and tell it to them. Yeah, it's one thing to even motivate them so that at the end of a talk they feel, yeah, I really want to get onto this. But it's another for them to implement it. So one of the things we really try to do in the course is to make it practical such that, you know, we bring in a principle, we talk about something, and then you practice it.
Earlier I would save, but once I save, I don't have a project in mind. But with this financial freedom, I've learned to save and invest. Because many people know how to save, but they think to invest you need big money.
In the beginning it was very complicated. I found it very difficult. But as I progressed, I thought, I think this is good. I am educating several people in secondary school. Some of the relatives that are not able to do that, and it with ease. I don't feel like I am getting squeezed to so much because I do that. I was able to also to, early this year, I was able to build a house for my mother.
Money will not create success. The freedom to create it will. Freedom comes from realizing that you are just but a steward and God owns it all. F4 is designed to guide you to a place of intentional stewardship of all the resources God has entrusted you with.
A bit different from what we thought it would be, but I think it has been very eye-opening.
It's possible to actually live a fulfilled life, and you don't have to journey through life in debt.
And really what I saw it doing for us, even as founders, is to just give us rest, that it's about God blessing the work of our hands.
When you go through the course and then you get a proper perspective and you realize that you're just but a steward.
Training such as this is very important.
I would urge everybody out there who would be interested in this program is to take it up.
I would want to also appreciate the financial freedom organizers because it's a noble thought they have come with, and the fact that they would want to expose as many people as they can, I think for me, I would want to appreciate them for that.